teams looking stark for a win. And we are set to go. The Coyotes start things off on the right note by winning the opening draw. Jostles for the puck, but still hangs on. Tremendous hit into the boards, and that's a finishing play.
He knew exactly what he was doing with that hit this early in the game. He's trying to send a message and dictate the pace.
Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. Arizona's on the attack. Here's a chance. Comes up with a big-time glove save. Gives him a jolt with that hit. Up to the challenge as he gets his pad on it. Under siege and finally grabs that one and covers up for a whistle. Lots of hockey left to be played this period. The game is still scoreless. Hayden's won the draw here and they'll go on the attack. Boston's looking to break out. Gaining steam here on the attack. Can't hang on to the puck after the play. Takes the feed. The Bruins have it now. Sends it over to McAvoy. Sporrel's got it along the wing. Oh, I thought he was going to be beaten, and he somehow got a piece of that. Here's a shot. Oh, what a close save. Whoa.
Gunther's been struggling to put up some numbers, and it can be frustrating to head into a pointless streak and continue. When that happens, you start to get down on yourself. It can really affect your confidence. You got to focus on the little things and try and keep good habits.
And he rings the post.
Van Riems had a tough time around the net tonight, James. It's hitting the bar.
Across the line and into the offensive end. Boston's got the puck along the wall. Just a little too much contact and couldn't hang on to the puck. Dermott's lugging the puck. And now he moves it quickly to Kerfoot. The Bruins grab possession to the puck. Here they come on the attack down the left side. And they score!
Hockey is a game of inches. If the pass isn't on the tape, if it's in your feet, all of a sudden you're fumbling for it, and that gives the coverage time to defend you. But this one, it's right on the money, and the goal is a result.
The Bruins are up by one here in the back half of the opening frame after that strike.
You know that the strategy has been one thing, put the puck to the net, and they have owned the shot share in the opening frame, no question about it, James. Now they find themselves with a one-goal lead. They got to continue to press to see if they can extend it.
And he makes the easy save.
What a save from point-blank range. I mean, he's in fabulous position, square to the shooter in the slot, and he makes the glove hand save.
The Bruins have had multiple scoring opportunities here in this first and could easily have a much bigger lead. Boston's won the faceoff. Quick shot. Trapper save. Didn't get all of it, but still enough. Ingram's got the puck, and he's going to hang on. Well past the midway mark of this period, the Bruins lead it 1-0. Boston's won the draw inside the offensive zone. Now let's see what they can do with it. Turns someone away. Puts it on net, and that shot dies in traffic. My goodness, this has been a pressure-filled shift here. Here's another shot. And there's the whistle. Needed stoppage. Here in the late goings of the period, we've got a 1-0 hockey game thus far. Arizona's got possession here in their own end. Bukestad's got it in the defensive end. Boston's gained possession along the boards. Gains the zone from the right. Center of game! feed. The Bruins ready to go on the attack. And that goes off someone in front and doesn't reach the net. Moves it to Bjugstad. Poked away at center by Fogler. Boston's got the puck against the half wall. Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that?
This is a dialed-in goaltender. Very aware, knows where the shooter is in that low slot and makes the save.
Moves the puck inside the offensive zone. Grabs control of it at the point. And he shuts the door on that. Nice zone entry from the middle. Here's a shot. Oh, at the buzzer, a big save. All right, time to get a clean sheet of ice here as period number one comes to an end. As you heard the horn sound, we'll be back with much, much more as this is going to be a fun one tonight.
Fans, we have a car on the east lawn with its lights on.
A chance for both teams to refuel. They're back on the ice, and period number two is about set to go. Second frame is underway as the puck is dropped. Well, we've seen a pretty good sample size already played thus far. Cheryl, your assessment.
Boston held the play here, and the reason why they've done it is they've controlled their shot selection. They know exactly where they want to go, when they're going to do it, and they're driving the net.
Picked up along the wall by McAvoy. Back to the point it goes. Moves into the slot. Big save by the goaltender washing that one.
The goaltender's at the last line of defense for a reason. This time, he bails his team out.
Pastrnak's accuracy comes from having the puck flat and settled on the ice, guys. His snipe zone ability is what really lets him pick his spots.
Boston's got the puck inside the offensive zone. Puck scooped up by Lindholm. And he takes a shot.
Finest.
Here's an opportunity in front of the net. The Coyotes gain possession. Valimaki's taking it from his own end. Through center along the wing. And he's knocked off the puck there. The Bruins gain control of the puck.
Face lines, come on!
And he's pulled over to the ice and loses the puck. Quick pass to McAvoy. Away. Kalamaki's got it in the defensive zone. Takes that pass back at the point. Fires it. Great stop by Ingram. Scrum ensues along the boards. And reads the play perfectly and picks off the pass. Schmaltz carries the puck in his own zone. Boston's got a hold of it along the wall. Sporles exploring options along the line. The Coyotes get a hold of the puck. Grabs it in his own end. Taken by Coyle. With possession along the wall. And that's deflected. The score! And that's back-to-back goals!
Well, nothing like switching momentum and putting your opponent on their heels than getting two in a row, back-to-back. Here they come. So much of the goaltending position is tracking the puck and trying to get the sight lines, James. And with only one player in front, you might lose it for a second. But if you out-battle and out-wheel the person in front, you're going to find it. Unfortunately, this puck, it beats him clean.
Inching closer to the midway mark of the period, the Bruins now lead by two. The Coyotes win it. And now he tries to get it across to Kraus. Pucks it away in his own end. The Bruins will play it from the defensive zone. Here they come on the attack. Carlos scores! The defender put it into his own net!
James, how surprised do you think the goaltender is? He just spins around and tries to clear the puck and he fires it past the tender.
The Bruins have been moving and grooving all night long, and we're only in the second period here, Pounder.
Well, they're finding a way to get the puck, and that's because they're retrieving it. But when they get it, they're keeping it. They're not letting anyone have it, and the motion in the offensive zone has been incredible. And the score is excellent.
Scores! And with that goal, I believe that is number 100 in point totals for his career.
Just check my notes, and you're absolutely correct, James. That would be the 100-point marker. Nice marker to get to, you know, showing some consistency in his game. As a goaltender, you're always working on different exercises, tracking with your eyes, foot movements, everything. That power pushes you across the crease, and unfortunately this time he's just too slow getting across, and it hits him and goes to the back of the net.
Boston's offense came to play in a big way, and they lead big time here in the second. Dumba's tripped up, and the official's hand is in the air, signaling penalty.
Anytime you lose position on your opponent, this can happen. He gets the sticks out in the feet of his opponent, and guess what? He gets the tripping call.
Our first look tonight at the power play unit.
First power play opportunity for this team. It's going to start in the faceoff circle, getting possession with the win, and then looking to set up.
Scooped up along the wall by Lindholm. Puck grab by Savard. That's blocked. Stopped by the goaltender. There's the whistle as the puck stopper elects to hang on. Lauko's side still shorthanded here as they slide in for the faceoff. The Coyotes start with the puck in their own end. Oh, he'll feel that one. They gain the zone from the left side. The Coyotes gain possession in their own end. Grabbed along the board by Zucker. The Bruins get a hold of the puck along the boards. Stopped by the goaltender, getting a piece of that one. Stuffs him again.
Well, you know that he's a fierce competitor, and he battled to make consecutive saves there, James. Especially teams create momentum, but not when you don't get it into the other zone, and the fans are frustrated in the building.
From the right side, he goes to the middle of the neutral zone. The Coyotes run it. Must go a step. Side in front. And he shuts down a great scoring chance there. The Bruins have a decided edge in the shot department and also in the score as well here in the second. Taken along the wall by Keller. Quick feed to Dermott. Through the neutral zone, up along the wing. The Bruins gain possession along the wall. Down the right wing and into the offensive zone. Here's a shot, and he easily stops that one. Goaltender covers it up, and we'll get a reset here. The Bruins are on cruise control here in the second. They have absolutely dominated. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Boston's got the puck. Too much congestion in front. Carlo's along the line, carrying the puck. Here in the corner, he grabs the puck. Can't connect as it goes off a stick. Picked up along the boards by Marchand.
Agree with you. They got the mojo. They're moving.
period number three. Game is not over yet. Let's see if they can try to rally back here in the third, but they've got a long way to go.
Well, two periods down. Here we go with the third period. Cheryl, your assessment so far.
Scores! He's on the board!
This is nothing new for him. His 20th goal of the season, James Gann. He's got an unbelievable ability to disguise his shot. Absolutely incredible.
20 already!
So what do you do, James? Your starting goaltender is out of the net. Your relievers come in and has just gotten peppered. Now you got to look to one another and say, man, what do we do next? There isn't a third goaltender. Guess what? The team has to pony up being countable in front of them.
Boston's offense continues to shine here in this third period.
Well, this has got to be a dream for a coach. You know that they're telling their team in the intermission to make sure they stay to business, stay to task, stay focused. And that's exactly what they've done, and they've just hammered their opponent.
And he takes the dish. Pasternak's got it against the boards. Puck picked up by Lindholm. Quick stop by Pavelka. The Bruins have been the busier team offensively, and as a result, they lead it big time here in this third. Boston's got it in the offensive zone. McAvoy's got the puck. Hammers a shot! Over it! It stays out! He got a piece of that one! The Bruins lead it here early in the third period. They have been dominant in the offensive area.
Here's the change.
Boston's won the draw. Can't make the play, and the puck leaves the zone. Here's a short pass to Pasternak. Drives to the paint, and that caroms off a body in traffic. Now he takes it over the line, dunks it in. Boston's got a hold of it against the wall. Oh, relentless pressure, and they come up with the turnover. The Bruins have it in the offensive zone. Moves it quickly over to DeBrusque. Lets it go to the slot. And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play. The Bruins are in the home stretch of this one here in the third period and lead by a wide margin. Arizona's got it in the defensive zone. The Coyotes will play it in their own end. Arizona's got the puck against the boards. And he comes up big with the stick save, getting all of it with the paddle. Slides it up to DeBrusque. Picks off the pass. Takes a spill onto the ice and loses the puck. Inside the offensive zone. Moves it to Zucker. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. The Bruins gain control of the puck against the wall. Takes the knock, but he's still got the puck. Pass back to the point. That goes wide. Boston's got the puck in the defensive end. And now it's grabbed by Frederick. Let's it rip. Way too much congestion blocks that. Arizona's got possession of the puck. Slides the puck to Fallamaki. They go on the attack from the left side. Back at the point, they set it up. There he is from the slot! And that goes off a body. Puck scooped up by Shattenkirk. Frederick's carrying it ahead.
Get him off!
Drives to the sweet spot! Gets a piece of it and will play on! Calgary's rolling in next on this home stretch, and the fans will be jumping for this one. Always a great contest when these two teams meet up. We're going to be there. I know Pounder's amped up for this one. We will see you then. Hopefully you'll join us. Halak's won the draw. Now look to set up. Taken here by Pasternak. Inside his own end, moves the puck. And it's a quick pass to Gunther. They go on the attack through center. Got a hold of the puck now. Quick pass to Marchand. Denies him! Here's a shot. Oh, and it's another save on the play. The Coyotes move the puck in the defensive zone. The Bruins take possession here in the open ice. Here they come on the attack. The Coyotes get a hold of the puck in their own end. play.
This is a penalty shot all day long. He was free and clear and was about to get the shot off and got tripped from behind.
And here we go. Great save on the penalty shot.
The penalty shot's always a game of cat and mouse, but I think he does a great job of not biting first. Patience and composure, he makes a save.
Boston's going to start with the puck in their own end. The Bruins have it now. Goes right to the crease. They score.
This is exactly why you send bodies to the front of the net, James. You want to create a screen in the corner.
Numerous times here in this third period. The Coyotes get a hold of the puck in their own.